You know, we're up on the north side of 60, right on the other side of Oak Flat. Now, there's a little turn off that's really hard to see, but we turned off in it. And we saw one of the most incredible sights that, I tell you, James, I don't know about you, but man, I tell you. There's just stacked rocks, okay? And there isn't just a little bit of it. This is in the area which looks to be a pen where they, you know, they would have held the goats is what I'm taking for granted. That's what this was the goat pen. But these walls run all the way across these hills. And they run all the way up and above and over the top. So it's not like they just build them on the ground. These walls are absolutely unbelievable. They're still standing, and I don't know if it was because maybe at that time they couldn't get poles dug into the ground to put barbed wire, or they didn't have barbed wire, or I'm not sure, but all I can tell you is the amount of work it would have taken to build these walls is unbelievable. And they're a work of art. I don't know how many hundred years they've been here, but I'm telling you what, they're a work of art. They're almost a ruin in themselves, wouldn't you say, James?
Yeah, man, these are just made by a different group of people, but definitely took the same amount of skill and time as the other places we've been.
No mortar, all loose rock, all just stacked.
Yeah.
And look at the amount of effort that work would have taken on this is unbelievable. And then this was an area that was a pen, it appears to be.
Yeah, and they go all the way up on the ledges. You can really imagine the effort involved in getting these rocks gathered and stacked in this kind of order. Pretty amazing.
Definitely worth the stop. If you're up here, it's definitely worth the stop just to see them, because to me, they're a work of art. They really are.
Yeah, this is another example of those roads we keep driving by, and eventually we just get curious enough that we pull off.
That even looks like those are stacked rocks right there. And I don't know what was up with that unless they roam through here too.
Oh, I would imagine this was to keep, yeah. Well, because there's more wall right there to the left too. Oh, water dumps off that.
Yeah, it's got to come off these cliffs pretty hard. Mm-hmm. Now we have stacked rocks at the ranch for cattle that are somewhat like this. But that's old time stuff, man. That's like old time stuff. You know, it possibly could have been for cattle too. Let's work our way back down. And they would have got done. Yeah, these are tracks right here. So they worked something back in this area. There's definitely a mine back here somewhere. There's also those pens that are goat pens, I was told. And man, you talk about goat farmers must have been, or ranchers, whatever you would call them, must have been pretty tough dudes, because the stone walls they built, my gosh, I mean, they're actually works of art. This is incredible, it really is. That used to be a lake right there. I wonder if that was swimming hole number three. I'll say that, maybe I'm wrong, but thank you. Use this.
Yeah, I know.
Jay Shrek, Myths, Legends, and Lies, and I'm with
James.
Where the hell are we, James?
I don't even know. We're outside of Superior.
Well,
right now.
We know one thing. We know that mountain range by now, right?
That's right.
Okay, so if you back it up, if you back that ass up, James, what you're going to find out is we're at the historic Pinal Cemetery, right?
We are.
It was used between 1876 and 1892. And pretty much the people of Pinal Town, which would have been right over that ridge, used this as their cemetery until they moved that town to what we know now as Superior. Now, there's one person here that's probably the most famous of the people that were put into this cemetery, would be Mattie Earp. And we've got some great news for you. There's only a few people that know where she is really buried at, because there are three locations. Now, what you're going to find from me is I'm not going to tell you the third location, but I will show you the first two. So if you're here, please be respectful. I can't believe, you know, they put that gate up, I was told, because people were driving four-wheelers through here and things like that. You know, it looks like most of the headstones didn't last, didn't make it, which is sad, but it's true, and that kind of happens. But if we walk right down through here, we can take a look and see that, like I said, there's three locations that she's buried at in this cemetery. And the first one that you will see is not her. So if you walk into the gate, no more than 20, 25 yards, you're gonna see Mattie Earp's grave right here, okay? And you're gonna see that. Now, regrettably, Mattie Earp is not here, okay? Now, why would they move her? Because people were trying to dig her up, man. James, what's up with that?
Well, people are being dicks, man, I don't know.
Isn't that crazy, though, that people would, you know, people would dig up graves. So now if you walk on, I'm going to say another about 20, 25 yards towards the picket post mountain, you're going to see an old rock wall where there is somebody buried, but you can't tell, which is kind of sad too. You know, somebody's here, but you don't know who. So if you go to here, okay. Now, if you go directly from this location here and you walk due south, right here, with this tree here, why don't you give me a shot back up there so they can see behind us, James? This is where she was originally buried, right here. This is her original grave. This is the grave that they moved when they were trying to, there were grave robbers trying to steal her body, right? She was right here. Now she's been moved from there, and I do know the location of where she's at, but I'm sworn to secrecy. Right, James?
Yeah, we can't give that one up.
Because, you know, I mean, it's sad that we got to be that way, but there's a lot of, you know, old graves. The only thing sad about some of these is, and there's supposed to be, I believe, 28 graves. And this looks to be a child, I'm going to guess. And then here's another grave right here. Now, here's a gravestone right here. Well, it looks like that. But what you'll do is if you look underneath some of the, like some of the growth, some of the trees, you'll find some headstones. But there's supposed to be 28 different graves here. And there's some people that are still prominent in the town of Superior have graves out here. Looked like a child there. Now, here's one that we actually have that we can actually see. Let me get a
Guzman.
Guzman.
This is a prominent member of the Superior community.
Died June 21st, 1916. Born in 1841. That's incredible. It really is. Now, I was told about these green posts. The whole reason they were put here has nothing to do with anything other than the fact that there, somebody was driving four-wheelers through here, which I can't even believe, but that's the truth. And that's what I was told. So these posts were put here just to protect the grave. And Guzman was supposed to be a very influential name, supposedly still is. And if you look over here, I mean, there's graves scattered all through here. I mean, this was a tough life if you lived this life.